Hey everyone, this is Gongum de-twix again, and today I'm going to be showing you my ultimate Khaimera deck. So, as you can see, 75% of the deck is focused on attack, 22 on health, protection, whatever, and 2% on mechanics. I'm not a big mechanics guy, that's part of my issue. But I hope you enjoy this deck, I hope you enjoy this video. The deck itself, I'll be uploading that video of me talking through it before I upload this one. I'm hoping my team comp works out well. We look pretty good. I mean, we got Countess, Aurora, Gideon, and then Morgesh. Because Morgesh right now, with her new release, is just kind of becoming a staple of teams right now. So, we will see how this goes. But my deck focuses on just dishing out damage very, very quickly. Okay, so that's going to be the main focus of me this entire time. I love my deck because my deck at the end of the day normally can beat almost any other Khaimera without any big issues. And this is the weirdest start to the game I've ever been in. We're getting in ginormous team fights already. We're all level 1, people. Oh, but I will take you. Ah, you piece of crap. Come on. Ah, crap. That one was my bad. I got overzealous after complaining about my team doing it. Okay, refocus, restart. Start jungling. Get that done. Please tell me this is not going to be how this game goes. Why are we all mid? Why are we all dying? That's the other question. Okay, jungle time. Jungle minions, here I come. Fear me. Someone push right lane, please. Oh, never mind. They're pushing right. I mean left. Push left lane. Get out of here, Countess. I called jungle before you even had the opportunity to. You decided to pick that character. And I get to defend a lane that's not mine. This game is already turning out to be a very fun and exciting game. And I get to lane. About my second favorite thing to do. You're supposed to be defending left lane, Countess. So yes, please defend it. I don't know what you're doing running around the middle. I don't know why we have three people mid either, though. I don't know. This laning thing's kind of... The last about four games I've played, I would say the laning's kind of gone down the tube very quickly. So normally, what winds up happening is... I've been playing Iggy and Scorch a lot lately. I'm going to be doing a video of them here soon because they have some big capabilities that I think people should know about, particularly after the last update. So that will be something I'll be going over. Come on, die. Sweet. So I'm going to be doing that. And with Morgesh, they actually work really, really good. Because they have longer range technically because of their turrets than Morgesh does. So I cannot tell you how entertaining it is to see Morgesh die by being flame broiled. Very, very satisfying. Okay, so I'll be showing you guys that here after a bit. But this morning, I just wanted to take some time, focus on my old school hero, Khaimera. He's always been one of my favorites. Crazy, he's amazing. I'm gonna go behind him and gank. And yeah, that's just pretty much Khaimera in a nutshell. Crazy, overpowered, some people say anyway. And yeah, and a lot of fun. A lot of fun regardless. Die, 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 minions. Why am I fighting minions? This is not my job. And Countess is just running around, just kind of doing whatever she wants. Come on, woman. Come on! I don't even know who you're saying good job to. But I should be saying good job to you. I should be that annoying teammate right now. Good job. You're in a lane you're not supposed to be in. Good job taking a lane like that. You must be so proud of yourself. So, so proud. Oh, push your butt all the way back to your base, sir. What type of shot was that? Come on. That was like the Matrix right there. I'll bend over out of the way and he shot in air. Perfect. It was amazing. I'm going back to upgrade my cards. And we're going to lose tower. Why is Countess back? Countess, learn how to jungle. Come on. I'm giving up my favorite position for you. That sounded wrong. I apologize, listeners with sensitive ears. That sounded inappropriate. I did not mean for that to sound that way. I'm really a very nice, kind of inappropriate guy. Just not that inappropriate. So, jungling non-existent right now for obvious reasons, because Countess has taken my jungle, and I'm not going to be that guy who's like, this is my spot. I'm going to just run around in the jungle and ignore left lane so we can lose while I'm throwing a hissy fit. Okay, I'm not that type of guy. I'm not going to be that guy. Alright, so I'm just not going to deal with it. I'm just going to do as best as I can in the lane. Get as many kills as I can, you know, do the whole shebag thing. And yeah, that's pretty much that. I just realized that guy has a Master Grim. And he's trying to defend that lane all by himself. So, the way I tend to play Khaimera and the way I build him, particularly not when I'm laning, but when I'm jungling, is to be using the Spirit Regeneration power heavily. Okay, it's... One is my favorite power that he gets. It's his favorite upgrade. And you guys get to listen to my dog here for a second. My apologies. Clickety-clack, 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 clickety-clickety-clickety-clickety-clack. Okay, but back to what I was talking about. It's probably one of my favorite abilities just because, I mean, you get bonus health regen for hitting people. And when you have a deck like mine that's extremely high damage, but I don't really focus at all on health or staying alive type abilities, the bonus health regen comes in major handy. Okay, it will really help you stay alive with this deck while you're just dishing out ridiculously huge amounts of damage. Which is probably my favorite thing. I'm okay if I die right now, actually. I took down the tower. I did some pushing. I get a card upgrade. Normally, I'm not this low on kills and this high on deaths, but also normally I'm jungling, not laning. So, there is that issue. Defend left lane. You can go defend left lane, Countess. That's where you should be anyway. Charge! According to the words of Khaimera, grr, grr, growl. Bah. That's how he sounds the majority of the time. Just, if he could talk, his main use of wording would be growl. You'll have to have subtitles like you're watching a foreign movie. Oh, man. And I still feel like his would just be like, me Khaimera, me hit type stuff. Me Khaimera, me hit you with axe, me slap you with axe. Just little things like that. Ooh, good, I just got coal, awesome. I should have pursued her harder. Oh well. I got her to run back, that's almost as good when it comes to Moragesh. But yeah, I kind of get the hate that Moragesh has been getting. That was pathetic, Countess. Maybe you should be jungling, actually. I'm giving you the honorary position of jungle. Because that was just sad in the lane. But yeah, I know all the hate Moragesh has been getting. Hey, Rocky. Rocky, can we please go lay down? Okay. I'm trying to shoot a video here, buddy. Okay? So can you go lay down? Thank you. I love my dog, but he's got the clickety-clack nails. No, he didn't go lay down. He's trying to check out the garbage to see if I left it open. I didn't leave it open! It's a pointless task, Rocket. An ally has been slain. Why is everybody dying? Ah! I sound like a gremlin there. That was bad. But yeah, I know all the hate Moragesh has been getting. Sorry, I keep getting off topic. I understand it. I play Moragesh a lot. She's one of my new mains. But I run her as a tanky main. You can find that video on YouTube on my channel. Of the deck, I haven't shot the video yet. I haven't got around to it. Like I said, with all the hate she's been getting, I've taken a little bit of a break from her. And more so than anything, I've been focusing on how to kill her. Just so people stop talking about how overpowered she is and that you can't kill her. Because Khaimera is a pretty good character to counter her with. You can get in combat quickly, you can dish out ridiculous amount of damage, your health regen can get really crazy. I mean, so many different things for her could be considered direct counters of what normally would be going on, okay? But of course, no, I don't know what I'm talking about, and she needs to be nerfed and everything else. Which I get, okay? A nerf would make her easier to beat. But I don't think that's the answer with this particular character, with how squishy she is. Okay, because I could understand it with Yin. I also play Yin a lot. Because she wasn't that squishy. And had a ridiculously high attack speed. And had lock-on attacks. And had ridiculous range. I mean, she was like the ultimately ridiculous hero. Okay? But I don't totally see that Moragesh. Because she has the hive, but you know she has it, and it's a 15 second countdown clock. So once she uses it on your minions, you know you have an open window for a while and stuff. So I just hope with playing Khaimera today, and I'm hoping to also play Iggy and Scorch today, to be able to show some characters that can counter her. Particularly Iggy and Scorch, because I love Iggy and Scorch, I always have. And I feel like they don't get much love anymore. Rocket, I'm going to put you outside in a minute, dude. Okay, I love you, dude, but your clicky-clack nails are a little hard on the ears. But yeah, that's kind of the general consensus for me with that. Is good character, bunch of potential. It's just we tend to try to counter her incorrectly, which is the main issue. So we try to go, well, she's a caster. And 1 second. There we go, now he's laying down. But we tend to think of her as a caster, a close range caster. And then for whatever reason, we tried to beat her at that game. I don't think there's any caster in this game right now that can beat Moragesh at close range casting. Okay? There are plenty of characters that can beat her in a close range melee fight. Or a long range shooting battle. Okay? Stuff like that. You have to play to her weaknesses and to your character's strength. And really, she is the only close-range caster that does that much damage. So, like, Gideon is not really a close-range caster. I've seen on Facebook a couple times people trying to claim, like, hey, Gideon's a close-range caster, yada, yada, yada. Why is he not as powerful as Moragesh? Well, because he can drop a rock twice as far as Moragesh can throw her high. And it does way more damage, people. I mean, that is no secret. His rock drop is way more devastating than Moragesh's beehive. Okay, I've died more times by his rock than Moragesh in the past 2 days. Okay, Moragesh has not killed me that much. Ah, you jerk. I really probably was the jerk, actually. Because I was about to steal that kill. Ah, I'm not gonna be able to kill him, you piece of crap. But yeah, I mean, there's ways around her. That's what I'm trying to say. You are gonna have to tinker to find it, but, I mean, you have to do that with any new character. I mean, play any MOBA, for crying out loud. I mean, play Paragon, play League of Legends, play Smite. Play anything where they're still creating new characters, and you have to find a way to beat that character. And until you find that way, they're gonna seem totally overpowered. Once you start to figure it out, though, it's just kinda, oh, this is actually easy. This is a lot easier. Like, when Aurora first came out, I didn't get all the hate she was getting. And how she was so overpowered because she had 2 escapes. Who cares she had 2 escapes? Because neither of those escapes did damage to you. So literally, it's like, you wanna run away? Go for it. You can't hurt me. And I succeeded in getting you to run. It's just the fact that a lot of Paragon has just turned into kill seeking. Which I think is kind of the sad thing about the game right now in the community. For us as players and stuff that take MOBAs really seriously, a lot of Paragon has started to just turn to, well, I want kills, and if I can't get a kill, the character's overpowered. And the reason I'm not in a big favor of that is mainly just because you can win a game and have everyone on your team go negative KD if you work together and just push the enemy back and get them to just recall back to base constantly. That's all you gotta do. And right there, you can win the game by doing that. Okay? But everyone's so big into kills right now that they're just like, well, if I can't kill them, they're overpowered. Well, yes, you can't kill them. But when Aurora's back at base, push her tower. When Morgash is back at base, push her tower. Or gank them. I mean, if you honestly want them to die, gank them. But then that requires us to share kills. Okay, so just I want to get the conversation going, just kind of get the general feelings of what I've been seeing a lot on Facebook, on the Paragon community pages and everything. It's everyone's just talking about kills now. No one's talking about team composition, no one's talking about lane pushing, no one's talking about really anything strategic. It's just like, hey, I got this many kills, I got that many kills. Stuff like that. And I get it, but I mean, it's like, come on. You don't need that to be the focus. Your focus should be winning the game as a team and having fun. I mean, come on. And normally you'll have fun if you're winning a game as a team. And you don't have a major issue with, like, everyone in the world. Also, what I mean by that is, because I mean, if you watch some of my videos, I get disgusted from time to time. And that's mainly has to do with kill stealing. I'm not so big into that. Just because it's like, I got that kill down to one hit health. I'm going to make that my new word, people. Whenever you hear me say health, know that it stands for one hit health. But whenever you get someone down to one hit health, and then someone just pops up in jacket, particularly Kaleri, or Khaimera, I should say. That kind of annoys me. Like, what just happened, I'm not really annoyed with, because we both did quite a bit of damage, okay? Kill stealing, I'm not in favor of. That type of sharing kills, I'm not in favor of. But it's just the overall focus of, like, I have to get all these different kills. I have to get so many kills. I'm the ADC, give me all the kills. Well, yes, you are the ADC. Okay, I'm not gonna deny that at all. But also at the same time, holy crap. Oh well, I gave a good counting of myself, and it looks like they're gonna kill him. So like that. I'm Khaimera, I'm made to get kills. Okay, they didn't come and help me immediately. I'm okay with that though, because look, we just killed two of them. Okay, you killed two of them off of my death, but I'm okay with that because as a team, we're profiting from this, okay? I got some more power points, I got quite a few more assists, my ELO is gonna go up if we win the game, okay? And that's the thing. Is people are like, well, my ELO won't go up if I don't get a bunch of kills. So that's bogus because your ELO doesn't go up, it goes down regardless of how many kills you get if you lose the game. Because you were pissed off that someone was helping you in your lane, helping you push it or whatever it is, okay? And this is the stuff that kind of drives me nuts. Okay, I'm going to stop talking about stuff that drives me nuts now. Okay, you are all beautiful people and amazing players. Okay, and we're going to get back to talking about this game in part 2 of the video. This is the end of part 1. I will see you guys for part 2.